So let's start things off with a huge congratulations to the one and only Burna Boy. You are an Apple Music Up Next artist. When you sing Oluwa Burna at the beginning of year, it's top two intros of all time. Do you know that?
Hmm.
I just want you to take that in. Just take it in. And now, hold on. Okay, second.
Do you know where the Oluwa Burna actually comes from?
Tell us.
From my actual name.
Tell my name us, is, elaborate for people that don't know.
My name is Damini Ebun Oluwa Ogulu. So it's like I just take out the Oluwa from the Ebun Oluwa and then I just say Oluwa Burna.
I could just play that bit of the song over and over again. I'm serious. It's just to me, it just signifies something great's about to happen. I really like it. It's one of my favorite things ever.
That's deep.
Tell me, give me some highlights from your life so far. We're what, nearly halfway through 2019. What have been some of the big
That's
points
mad,
of this
you know,
year?
We actually are.
Mm-hmm. Life, time is going fast. Trust me.
Oh, the year just started, man.
What have been some of your highlights?
Man, starting the year, going to Ghana.
Why Ghana?
Because like that's the only place I have like actual genuine peace. Man.
Okay.
You get me? It's like when you go to like Labadi Beach. And then you're looking in the water, man. And then, like, you see there's this line at the end where it's like it separates the sky from the water.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like that's where God lives.
So you started in Ghana.
Yeah.
Got your peace. And then where next?
I go on mad robot mode.
Mm-hmm.
Where it's like I'll do like 4 shows a day.
Right, yeah, right? Yeah.
At the end, I'll just break down
the
totally.
The robot breaks.
Yeah. And then that's when I go to Ghana.
Right. What were some of the things in your mind that you said you want to attack this year? Because I feel like, I don't know if you've noticed it, but for me, sitting in the UK, the love for you has grown. I hear you everywhere amongst all people now, not just in certain communities.
I didn't even know I had
Oh, really?
That, to be honest. I just thought people like to come to my shows and watch me perform. I didn't know like it was real, like it was actually growing really like that. Because first of all, I'm making music for myself. First of all, I'm not making, like, for me that I like I would, for me to listen to.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? Like that was the gain at first. That was the point.
When was the bit where you said, oh, okay, I'm not just Oluwa Burna making music for myself?
2014.
Okay.
That's the first time like I did a show in a stadium in the eastern part of Nigeria where it's like they only like their own people type shit. So like if you've crossed over there, then like
it's a big deal.
You've popped. You get me? And you're not from there.
Yeah.
And you cross over there, you know. Like, I've never seen nothing like that in my life. I didn't even think it was real. It was a real thing that could happen.
Okay, so let's go back to early days.
Mm.
Let's go back to day one. So 2nd of July, you're born, 1991.
Mm.
You come into this world, you do what? What are you interested in? Who was early Oluwa Burna? Even though, obviously, people weren't calling you that from young.
I was interested in, like, Naughty by Nature music.
Yeah.
My dad brought the Super Cat and then my mom would have the Anita Baker's and all them things.
Okay,
And then my uncle, who was a bit younger, had more of the Naughty by Nature's and all that. So yeah,
it was everything.
Yeah. And then my granddad was Fela's manager, so you know how that went.
Exactly, yeah. Of course.
Me personally, I was playing a lot of football, like.
Were you good at it or did you just like playing?
Yeah, I was good. But the wickedest thing is I was good at goalkeeping.
Why? Why is that? What?
Like, that's why I just stopped because, like, it was dead.
No, come on. Wait. The goalie is a very important part of the team.
Yeah, no, but, like, I didn't feel so important, man. Like,
you just didn't feel like you was the star of the, of the team.
Yeah, it's not even the star. Like, I just didn't feel like I was needed like that.
<That's hilarious.
laughs> You get me? I felt like without me, they'd still be all right. You get me? So, like, what am I doing?
Said,
I don't
want to
spend my life like that, you know?
What happened? When did you stop playing?
Early.
Oh, really?
Early.
Talk to me about being from Nigeria, traveling around, you know, making the music that you make, and then taking that sound outside to places where people don't necessarily understand who you are and where you're from. Where were the places where you thought, okay, cool, they get me and they understand my heritage and my culture?
The first place is definitely the UK.
Mm-hmm.
This is, for me, it's like my second home. And then I don't even need to go into detail with that one because, like, it's the UK, isn't it?
Yeah. Why do you think there are places like the UK now where we can have a chorus sung by a Nigerian-born human and the country singing it?
So it comes down to roots. If you go to, like, let's say America or any other place like that, or Jamaica or something, and then you ask a black person, hey man, where you from? They're going to tell you I'm from Dallas. So
I
I'm
can't
from...
believe you're going to say this.
Nah, hold on, hold on.
No, no, no,
hold on,
not in
on.
A bad way. I had this conversation the other day and I can't believe that you think the same thing as me.
Yeah,
no,
it's
continue.
Real. So they're going to tell you I'm from Dallas, so I'm from St. Anne's or Spanish Town. But if you come to London or the UK and you ask a black person, you say, where are you from? They're going to tell you Nigeria or mm-hmm. Ghana or Zion.
Yeah.
You get me? Even the one that's going to tell you Brixton or Hackney or whatever, it's going to, and you ask them again, no, like, where are you
parents from?
Where
yeah.
you from, like, in
yeah.
Africa?
Yeah.
They'll tell you.
Yeah.
Sierra Leone or you get me? Gabon or Gambia. They'll tell you.
Mm-hmm.
They actually know.
Yeah.
So they have roots. Do you understand? So they understand, like, it's part of them. You get me? It's part of you. It's part of, you get me? You know your name is Julia Adenuga.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand?
Yeah. I think a lot of African-Americans, what they call themselves now, black people in America,
mm-hmm.
they were stripped of that.
Exactly.
Whereas when we came to... when my parents came here,
yeah.
no one told us to not
yeah.
be that way.
Because nobody forced you to come here.
No, yeah, that's true as well. That's true as
you
well.
You know, so it's
yeah.
like you came here as as with the same royalty mm-hmm. that you had.
Yeah,
you get me. Nobody yeah. took it away.
So where do your collaborations with Dave, with Lily Allen, what do you think about those when you think about your career to date? How important are those things to you?
Man, they make me feel great, man. Because like you gotta understand, like. Me, when I used to live here in the UK, it's like I'd watch on TV and stuff and all the, like I'd never go, but like I'd see how the festivals and thing and then Lily Allen's and the N Dubs and them thing there.
Yeah.
And like, I had like, that was a part of me, innit? Like, so yeah, man, like coming here, that was always something I thought, yeah, I was going to do.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
You done
it. And it all happened organically because I don't think I've ever like said, yeah, I want to do work with that person and that person.
Hey. So the official announcement for your album has come out, yes? It's
mm-hmm.
called African Giant.
Yeah.
That's the name of the brand new album.
Yes.
What, at this point in Burna Boy's career, do you want this album to do? What is its purpose for you?
I feel like the album is giving you a part of me.
Exactly.
Like a part of me and a time in my life.
Exactly, yeah.
You get me?
Do you feel any sort of pressure or responsibility?
Nope.
None at all?
Nope.
Was there a time where you did feel some?
Nope.
Really?
No, I only feel that I'm like the firstborn son of my parents, so
yeah.
I always feel responsibility for the family.
For the family, yeah.
Certain things. But like when it comes to music and what I do as a job, and as it's not even as a job because to me music is not a hustle, it's art.
I can't wait for everybody in the world to get to know you now, even more than they did before.
Yes,
I look forward to more shows all over the world.
Most definitely.
And congratulations on everything so far, man.
Thank
and
you
I can't
so
wait
much.
For the new album as well.
Bless you.
Thank
bless
you.
You.